Now, while Spotlight has definitely provided some improvements to productivity, it's not the only service that does. Shortcuts has leveled up as well by providing us with automations. Now, automations are great. Just think of elements of Keyboard Maestro, throw in a few bits of Hazel, and you've got some of those automation capabilities in Shortcuts now. And I'm going to show you a couple of simple examples of how to use them. So with Shortcuts open, there's an automation section in the sidebar, which I'm already in. And to add an automation, click plus up here. And the kind of automations that you can add are here. So I'm just going to run through them, and then you can think of how you would potentially leverage these as I go. So time of day, very simple. Actions that will run on given times of the day. And we're going to be running one of these next. You can have automations that run when something happens with your alarm. So perhaps when you turn off your alarm in the morning, your sleep focus mode stops and changes to a morning or home one. Or maybe it automatically turns on some lights in your bedroom. You can have automations take place when you get an email from a certain person or if the subject contains a certain word or phrase. And the same goes with a message that you receive. That can kickstart an automation too. There are file-based ones, and we'll demonstrate one that takes place when a file hits a folder. You can have them too for when a given file is modified or when an external drive is connected. We've got connectivity-based triggers down here that take place when you join a specific Wi-Fi network or a Bluetooth accessory is joined, as well as displays as well. You can even automate when Stage Manager is turned on. You can set automations for when specific applications are started and when your device is on battery or mains power. And then finally, we have automations that kick off dependent on the focus mode that you're in. You really are spoiled for choice. But we're going to run a simple automation first that takes place at the start of the working day. So I'm going to set this for time of day. Now, the time at the moment is 11 minutes past 3 as I record this, and I don't want to wait until 9 a.m. to run this. So I'll set this for, let's say, 3:30. And then when we've set this up, I'm just going to pause until that time. Alternatively, you can set it for sunrise or sunset. And if you want to repeat this, then you can set it for daily, weekly, or monthly. Now, by default, it's only going to run after you confirm it, but alternatively, you can set it to run immediately. And once you do set that, you can set it to notify you when it has actually been run. Now I click next, and we have to determine what is going to happen. Well, there are some suggestions that you can set here at the top. Then below that, you can choose a shortcut that you've already set up in the Shortcuts app. For these automations though, I like setting up brand new ones. So I'm going to click New Shortcut. Then I'll give it a name. So this will be Morning Focus. Now let's start putting some actions in there. Well, at 9 a.m, what do I want to happen? Well, let's open OmniFocus, my task manager. So I'll search for Open App and I'll drag this across. I'll just click App here and my application list appears. So I'll search for OmniFocus. There it is. And what else shall I do? Well, I want to open my calendar as well. So I'm just going to right click on this action here and then duplicate it, because then I can quickly click here and just change this to calendar. Now, when calendar opens, I want it to display the today view. I don't particularly need to see the weekly or the monthly first thing, just the today one. So I need to send a keyboard shortcut to achieve this. So I'm going to search for shortcut, and send keyboard shortcut is down here. I'll drag this across. And I love this particular action because you can just build what you want. So the shortcut for getting to the today view in calendar is command and one. So I'll turn on the command key here and then add one in here. I can specify the application I want to send that shortcut to if I wish, but because this is taking place straight after it opens calendar, calendar's going to be active. So I don't actually need to specify an app here. Okay, let's clear this. And I'm going to activate a focus mode with this shortcut as well. So I'm going to drag set focus across here. And I want to set the work focus. And let's put a time on this as well. This is only going to be active until 5 p.m. Good stuff. Now, what else can we do? Well, I can't really work without music, so let's open an app again. And this is going to be the music application. Now, I could set this to play a certain album or playlist, but to be honest, I love all my music and I work to a wide variety of it. So I'm just going to set this to play whatever was playing last. I'd use this action to target specific music here if that's what I wanted to do. Okay, let's clear this. And we're going to do just one more thing with this shortcut. We're going to create a daily note in Apple Notes for note taking. I'm going to right click on this content attribute here and change to insert a variable. And the variable is going to be the current date. Now, where is it going to place it? It's going to be in the daily notes folder. I want it in there. Okay, I think we're done. Now, this is going to go off at 3:30. But actually, as I look at the clock, it's actually over 10 minutes away. So I'm just going to edit this time and change this to 3:20. Okay, that's done. And I'm going to pause. Okay, we're a few seconds away from, hopefully, the automation working. Okay, there's OmniFocus. There's the Canada. There's music. And it's press play. So we've got some classical music coming through there. Notes opens. There's a new note. And I could, of course, tweak this and send a keystroke to hide these applications with Command and H when they open. Or I could set up another automation that closes them at 5 p.m. There's lots and lots of options here for you. So that was a time of day automation, but what about a file-based one? Well, if you want to perform automation on your files, this won't completely replace tools like Hazel. But if you don't need the complexity of that app, then this could well be enough. So I'm going to create an automation that happens when something happens to a folder. Now, what this is going to do, quite simply, is when an image gets added to the desktop, and that's usually a screenshot, what it's going to do is it's going to lift it and move it to a dedicated folder. Very simple. So the folder that I want to monitor is desktop. And I can perform actions when items are either added to the folder, if anything is modified within it, or if something is removed. Well, I want added for this example. I want it to run immediately. I don't want to have to think about it. And then I'd like a notification when it is actually run. So here I want to build my own new shortcut again. So I'm going to give this a name, first of all. It's going to be Move Screenshots. And let's add our first action. So when something is added, we want to filter the files because we only want this happening to image files. So I'll click Files here, change this to Shortcut Input. Then if I right-click this, I can select exactly what I would like to filter on. Well, I'm filtering on files that have been added. And what exactly are these filters going to be? Well, I need to click Add Filter for this. And then I'll select the attribute. So this should be file extension. And I'm going to change anything here to PNG. So this will filter and action any PNG files. I want more though. So I'm going to click plus, file extension. I'll make this one JPG. Okay, I did just quickly pause there so that we can have our four file types. Now I just need to come up here and make sure that I change this word all to any. Okay, what next? Let's clear this. And I want to repeat this with each item that gets added. And we need to define what we are repeating. Well, we're going to be moving the file. So I'm going to drag this. And we're moving the repeated item. Now, if you ever get confused as to which variable applies to which action, you can always click Select Variable here. And you can see the variable names that are created after each action that takes place in the flow. So this action here creates the repeated item. So that is what we want in here. I just need to now select it. Then I'm going to change the folder that the files are going to be moved to. So I want it moved to a folder I've got in iCloud Drive called Screenshots. Well, it's actually a folder in Screenshots that is also called Screenshots. This is the one that I want to use. So I'll click Open and then the repeat ends. So that is the automation setup. I'm going to close and we'll get ready to action it. Okay, I've just opened that destination folder where the screenshot will move to. So I'll just create a new screenshot and save it to the desktop. And for this, I'll press Shift Command and 4. I'll just select this area here. Now I'm using CleanShot X for this, so I have a preview down here on the left. I'll click to save. It's on the desktop here, but not for long. The automation has run. So now it's moved into the screenshots folder as per our ask. And there is the notification telling us so. So it's seriously useful for file management, and there are going to be lots and lots of great examples of how this is going to be used now that Tahoe is out. I'm looking forward to looking at some of these myself.